To your sanctuary, we have come to adore you, Lord. Into your sanctuary, we have come to adore you, Lord. In adoration and praise, we glorify your holy name. Into your sanctuary, we have come to adore you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of life in us. We reverence your holy name, O our God. To your sanctuary, we have come to adore you, Lord. Into your sanctuary, we have come to adore you, Lord. In adoration and praise, we glorify your holy name. Into your sanctuary, we have come to adore you, Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, indeed, we thank God for this great opportunity to have seen this first day in the month of March. Today being the 1st of March 2021, we have come to adore you, Lord. We are coming to your sanctuary to worship you, to reverence your holy name. And to thank you for the precious gift of life that you've given us. For every one of you listening to this word of God, for every one of you following us on social media, I pray that the good Lord will fill your heart, will bless this month and make it a fruitful and a joyful month for you and I, in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, I want us to reflect on this topic. Mercy goes both ways. My reflection will be on the first reading of today, taken from the book of Daniel chapter 9 verse 4 to 10. And also the gospel text, Luke chapter 6 verse 36 to 38. We know what the golden rule of life is. It is essentially this: do unto others what we want others to do unto us. We can find the expression of this rule in almost every religion. Jesus also taught this golden rule of life, as we read in Gospel of Matthew chapter 7 verse 12 and the Gospel of Luke chapter 6 verse 31. In our gospel reading of today, taken from Luke chapter 6 verse 36 to 38, he teaches us not to judge or condemn. Yet Jesus also taught much more and deeper. When he talked about compassion, it is not so much that we hope that we will receive compassion in return. Instead, we are to be compassionate because God is compassionate. And in creating us, he has already filled us with his compassion. It is compassion that is without limit. In our first reading of today, taken from the book of Daniel chapter 9 verse 4 to 10, the prophet confessed that the people acted wickedly, broke God's commandment, and turned away from God. That is simply because they forgot that God is compassionate and that they were already filled with his compassion. Hence, they committed wicked deeds. The Lenten discipline of prayer and fasting and almsgiving helps us to control the aggressiveness of our human reactions to people who cut into our path. At the same time, the Lenten discipline also helps us to bring out compassion for others, to understand them without conditions, and to see things from their point of view without judging them. Saint Ignatius of Loyola, in his guide for a 30-day retreat, has the retreatant spend the first week of the retreat focusing upon sin, judgment, death, and hell. At first, this can seem very uninspiring. I went through similar experience. It was somehow boring. But the wisdom of this approach is that after a week of these meditations, I tell you from experience, just like every other retreatant, I come to a deep realization of just how much we all need the mercy and forgiveness of God. We see their need more clearly. We see the need of God's mercy more clearly, and a deep humility is fostered within our soul as we see our guilt and turn to God for His mercy. But mercy goes both ways. It is part of the very essence of mercy that it can only be received if it is also given. In the gospel passage above, Jesus gives us a very clear command about judgment, condemnation, mercy, and forgiveness. Essentially, if we want mercy and forgiveness, then we must offer mercy and forgiveness. If we are judgmental and condemning, then we will also be judged and condemned. These words are very clear. Perhaps one of the reasons that many people struggle with being judgmental and condemning others is that they lack a true awareness of their own sin and their own need for forgiveness. We live in a world that often rationalizes sin and downplays the seriousness of it. That is why the teaching of St. Ignatius is so important for us today. We need to rekindle a sense of the seriousness of our sin. This is not done simply to create guilt and shame. It's done to foster a desire for mercy and forgiveness. If you can grow in a deeper awareness of your own sin before God, one of the effects will be that it is easier to be less judgmental and condemn others. A person who sees his sin is more apt to be merciful to others, other sinners. For those who show mercy, they can easily show mercy to others. For those who experience the mercy and the love and the compassionate love of God, for those who really experience it, to be easy for them to be able to live it. But a person who struggles with self-righteousness will most certainly also struggle with being judgmental and condemning. My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, I invite us today to reflect upon our own sin. Spend time trying to understand how ugly sin is, and try to grow in a healthy disdain for it. As you do, and as you beg our Lord for His mercy, also pray that you will be able to offer that same mercy you receive from God to others. As mercy flows from heaven to your own soul, it must then also be shared. Share the mercy of God with those all around you, and you will discover the true value and power of this gospel teaching of our Lord. Let us open our hearts for God to continue pouring forth His compassion. His compassion of full measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over into the heart of others. I pray for every one of you out there, and I pray that the good Lord will continue to inspire each one of you as we begin this new month, that God will help us to live a better life as Christians and followers of Christ. I encourage us to reflect on the book of Daniel chapter 9, verse 4 to 10. And also the gospel reading from the gospel of Luke chapter 6, verse 36 to 38. And also, if we can, let's reflect on the gospel of Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. And the gospel of Luke chapter 6, verse 31. As we do that, the good Lord will speak through our hearts. The good Lord will reach out to us. I pray for every one of us today. Our merciful Jesus, we thank you for your infinite mercy. Help us to see clearly our sins so that we in turn may see our need for your mercy. As we do, dear Lord, we pray that our hearts will be open to that mercy so that we can both receive it and share it with others. Make us a true instrument of your divine grace. Jesus, we trust in you. May Almighty God bless every one of you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.